Well, I'll tell you something, that's a very interesting start. So what you picked actually did happen, unlike what it did in the PS3 playthrough. So that's, maybe they've took 2 years to make it. Maybe this is a proper remaster, like Gears of War Ultimate was. Guess we'll see. Let's continue on here. I'm already liking it. Well, now we're at home. Oh, wait a minute. Why is she in bed here? I haven't played this in 3 years, so I've got to try and remember what the order was. Oh. Oh, okay. So that was the night before, and then we go to this scene. Yep, that was
Hey,
correct.
honey, you can't spend the whole day looking out the window. Why don't you find something to do?
I'm surprised they didn't, have the revelation cutscenes. If you remember at the end of the near the end of the game, you figure out what had happened to her and what the situations were. It's surprised they haven't started with that yet. But I guess what they're doing here is they're starting from a life as a kid, so it probably makes more sense. I was kind of thinking maybe they'd done the cut. They probably would have started the cutscenes from when, if you remember, like not Defoe. What's his name? Dawkins? Nathan Dawkins, is it? When Nathan Dawkins receives her and stuff. Or maybe this was before then. Maybe that was before then. Maybe. What do we do? We can go upstairs, I think. One of them is our the dad's room, so here we go.
Do you want to come over to my house for tea? Oh, yes, I'd love to. Okie dokie, we'll go in my car. I love your car.
I'm just thinking, like, this was.
Yeah, I chose it myself, and it goes really, really fast.
This was before the parents give her up to Dawkins. So I'm surprised we started with that experiment thing in the. In the first place, but maybe that was due for tutorial reasons, maybe.
We're here. Come on, let's go this way. What a beautiful house you have. Yes, I love it a lot. My husband gave it to me for my birthday.
Wow, that's a lot of money.
Would you
A
like some
house
sugar
for a
in your
birthday
tea, Fairy
present.
Blossom?
Oops.
And how is your husband? He's good. He's working.
Huh.
Why, he's so handsome.
What the hell?
Stop that, Aiden. I told you I didn't want to play with you anymore.
God damn it, Aiden. The revelation at the end of the game made everything make sense. Make Aiden's presence make complete sense. I'm not sure if I did this in the playthroughs, or this will be new. Kind of reminds me of the start of Heavy Rain, really. When you do that drawing for his work and stuff? Funny. She always kept that, by the way. You'll notice that later. kind of a shame that you don't, like, have this thing in Life is Strange where she just talks or thinks to herself. But unfortunately, you can't do that. Aww. let's see. She looks like thoroughly bored. Oops. Oh God. Jesus, that scared even me. Little jump scare. Shit. What do we do to make her go outside? I'm trying to remember what I did. Let me get something from her mom or something. Cookies.
Can I have a cookie?
It's almost dinner time, sweetheart. You eat a cookie now, you won't eat your dinner.
Fair news. Do we just talk to her mom, do we?
Come on, honey, I gotta get dinner ready.
God damn it. What do you do? Shoot, I know you do something. See? Oops.
Jody, honey, would you do me a favor?
Oh, here we go.
Could you get me a bottle of oil from the garage?
Sure, no problem.
I'm right here. No need to shout. Yeah, I remember now. Because that happened in my PS3 playthrough, that actually happened when I was upstairs. Shoot. Hang on, I'm kind of retracing my steps here, it's Christmas. Oh, that's convenient. It's freaking Christmas in the game. Forgot about that. No, that's outside. Sorry, I'm trying to find the blinking garage now. Because I can't remember where it was. Down here, isn't it? There it is. Huh, figures. Now I believe there's something here that you can just kind of get what you need and walk out. But if you take too long, something else happens. So I think this might be where the choice is. Just need to find what we're looking for. It was over here, is that, wasn't it? There it is. It's alright, Jody. Keep moving. It's hella cold. Shit. Go. Straight up a door. Straight up a door. There we go. Awesome. I think what Beyond tried to do was not make the choices as great importance as they did in Heavy Rain, but kind of give you alternate cutscenes depending on what you did.
Thanks, sweetheart.
Which is what that whole first thing was about. Do we talk to our mother? Or did she just say to go outside? Here we go.
Sweetheart, why don't you go outside and play?
There we go.
I'll call you when dinner's ready.
Gotcha. I'm trying to rechange my steps here. Yeah, I think what Beyond was different to Heavy Rain is that the choices don't really carry as great a weight throughout the game, but the choices you actually do make change the kind of cutscenes and things like that. But that first scene caught me off guard, like... That first scene caught me off guard, like I never expected that because that never happened in the PC, the PS3 playthrough. I didn't do anything.
Great, now it can be bored and freezing. But you don't care, do you, Aiden? You never get cold.
Oh, look at that. Is that there? I don't know if that was there in the PC. I keep calling it PC. PS3 playthrough. Mind you, it has been 3 years since I played it, but I know for a fact that that scene there was new. That was definitely something I hadn't seen before. Do you know, I have a thing when it comes to all these remasters. All these remasters that have come out. It's funny, because, like, Eurogamer said, said a tweet saying, remasters, are we all getting sick of them? And a lot of people were like, yeah, I'm sick of them, and yeah, I'm sick of them, and it's like, yeah, yeah, we're annoyed. But they had no problem voicing that they wanted backwards compatibility for both consoles. Now, isn't that funny? You know? People sit and complain about remasters, but they want backwards compatibility for both these consoles, and I'm like, I don't get it. Like, why? People would rather have backwards compatibility playing versions rather than remasters of popular games like this.
Okay, I know we're not supposed to. Come on, we'll just play for 5 minutes and come back. Mom will never know.
But yeah, it's like, everybody has no problem playing backwards compatibility games on Xbox One, say Fallout 3 or Gears of War 2 to Judgment, but have a problem with popular games like Gears of War Remastered, Beyond Two Souls Remastered, Heavy Rain Remastered's coming out, you know, the popular games. Now, I understand that some people could be referring to remasters, say, Rayman Legends. You know, because what on earth did that come out as a remaster for?
You can at least you
know?
Give me a hand, Aiden.
Oops. You know, I can understand that. It has to be a remaster that makes sense.
Aiden, you're the best.
But, you know. What's the button? I can't see it. Oh, there we go. I couldn't see it. It was all white. But yeah, it's just like, people would rather, it seems to me like people would rather play backwards compatibility on Xbox One or PS4 rather than a remaster. And it's like,
you wanna play with us?
That's what I came here for.
Hide, then. You're gonna get cream.
Let's go. Huh. I remember this.
I'm gonna make you pay for that.
Where are the kids? Shoot. I missed. Shoot!
Hey, get me.
That was hardly fair. Awkward.
Come on, let's get him.
Shit. What are we aiming? What kid are we aiming for? Oh, I suck.
Hey, you missed me.
I suck at throwing snowballs. What are we doing? There we go. Boom. Boom. Right in the face.
It hit you right in your face.
Boom. Oh, what?
You're a dead little girl. I got you.
Now, can we actually stop this, or do we have to trigger it a little bit? No, I think we do have to trigger it slightly. So it was only a little bit, but I don't think if I hadn't done anything, it probably would have...
Did you see that? She nearly killed me! You saw what she did to me? She's a witch! A dirty, rotten witch!
What's going on here?
She's a witch!
Do you
I'm telling you! Jody Holmes is a witch!
Okay.
Come on. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Get in the house.
What happened?
What were you doing in the street? You know you're not allowed to leave the yard.
Saw the other kids playing. I just wanted to have some fun.
What did you do to that boy?
Philip.
I didn't do anything. I didn't do it. He was trying to defend me. He thought...
I'm sick and tired of your stories.
Yes, except for the fact that you were told about this. See? I believe they were told about it anyway. But yeah, like I said, what Aiden does will make sense at the end of the game when you figure out what he is. It makes sense. But, you know, times like that, I think of what people were really critical about. Like, you could have chose not to do anything, but you had to do it to advance the plot. I think that's what a lot of people kind of criticized there.
But,
yeah, it's kind of annoying. I guess we'll see where the choices show up, actually. Well, how that changes anything.